Right, as we come to the end of the program, let's get into the danger zone, shall we? And who can forget this iconic stunt? A young Kim Pratley, he's a bit older now, I'm going to introduce you to him in just a moment, literally betting his life on the strength of Pratley adhesives as a 13-ton bulldozer hung precariously overhead. So that bulldozer has been hanging there, I tell you, ever since. Has only recently been taken down for a fresh coat of paint. Well, Pratley Adhesives is revisiting this famous execution as it celebrates its 70th anniversary. I'm joined by three members of the Pratley family. Kim, he's the one with the beard, and brothers Charles and Andrew, to talk about this iconic moment in advertising and how they think the reenactment is going to help them connect with a new generation of consumers. Kim, to you first of all, you don't look that much older.
Thank you.
Did you need your head read at the time?
Yeah, a lot of people ask me that. And, you know, it was all about credibility.
Yeah.
That advert was a credibility ad. And we were launching a new product at that time called Wonderfix. And Wonderfix had some very unique properties. It was a patent that we had developed.
Yeah.
And we wanted a new angle. We stuck the joint together. We hung the bulldozer. I stood underneath. And my wife was actually watching, and somebody standing next to my wife, you know, said, I wonder what his wife is thinking. But no, I didn't need my head read. We understand adhesives.
Yeah.
The joint wasn't going to break. And, you know,
people... Come on, Kim, there must have been moments of anxiety as you're standing under that bulldozer.
I often use the analogy of someone in a lift in a building. You're actually hanging by a very small piece of rope.
Which is why I use the stairs, yeah.
Indeed. Yeah. but you're hanging by a very small piece of rope, and people understand that engineers have designed that rope. And we understand adhesives. We stuck the plates together, and really there was no danger.
I presume you took Keyman Insurance out at that point, but you don't have to answer that question. So, whose idea was it, and I'm assuming maybe, Andrew, it was yours, maybe it was yours, Charles, to revisit this?
I think it was a little bit of both. Yeah. I think we wanted to do the same thing, but bring it a little bit more to a younger audience as well, you know? Mm. I think, as my dad was saying, it's all about reliability. And if we can show that also to a younger generation, that reliability is still there. The joint was hanging for a number of years,
yeah.
And we wanted to show that it's still as reliable as it was before. I came up with a little bit of the concepts, bounced it off my dad a little bit, off Charles, and eventually we came up with...
So, Charles, I see that you're the engineering manager, technical services.
That is correct. So
a lot of this is kind of resting on you.
Yeah,
don't mess it up.
So if the joints had come down, everyone would have looked at me, but yeah. Luckily it didn't. As you said, I'm an engineer, so every day I go past that joint and see that it's hanging still. Mm. And everyone, all my friends say to me, you must be mad standing under that bulldozer. Mm. But
The younger two of the Pratleys, were you still around? I mean, you must have been much younger when all of this happened.
It was 1985, yeah. So I think I was about, 3 years old, I think, at the time.
Yeah, it was a year after I was born.
Yeah, so you don't really have any recollection of seeing your dad actually standing up there. What was it like sitting under the bulldozer? I mean, were you completely
me?
Were you completely confident?
Yes, indeed. Yeah, as I said, you know, we are adhesive experts. That's where our expertise lies. Mm-hmm. We have a lot of world-leading technology. Mm-hmm. We do a lot of research and development. And we understand adhesives. So yeah, the joint would not have broken.
God, it's an absolutely fascinating story. What about the new execution now? So you're revisiting this 30 years on.
In the new incarnation of the advert, we wanted it to have the same sort of look and feel as the old advert, but we wanted to incorporate a little bit of the staff that's involved in the background of Pratley as well. We took my dad's original script and we got him to start it off. But then, after a while, bring people who are involved in the company to also say a few words in that script. And then, at the end, bring in kind of the new generation and end it off, just to show that there's going to be...
And Charles, they will also be under the bulldozer at some point?
The staff?
Yes.
No, we don't put them under the bulldozer. A lot of them want to go under the bulldozer, but we just keep it us three.
Okay, because it's kind of like the family thing.
The family thing.
I presume you guys. I mean, it's been hanging there for such a long time. I mean, lots of people. I mean, it's probably come out of the furniture now.
Every morning when I walk in, past the bulldozer and it's been standing there still. So,
it's kind of a reminder of like why we go to work every day. You know? You kind of pass it and you look at it and you think, there's kind of not a day where you think, well, actually.
You're doing some good because you've stuck a bulldozer on the roof.
Some of the older viewers may recall William Smith. Yes. He was the
science guy.
The science guy.
That's right.
He
helped many of us pass matric.
Indeed. he also stood under the bulldozer or sat under the bulldozer at one stage as a good friend of ours. Yeah.
Just very quickly as we wrap this up, and it's a fascinating conversation, and I'm looking forward to seeing the new incarnation. The business itself, I mean, you talk about new patents coming on board. I'm assuming it's become a lot more sophisticated 30 years on.
Yes.
The science, the technology has become
a
whole lot more
critical. Yeah, absolutely. You know, most people know us for our adhesives because they are the products that we sell to the consumers. But in fact, we have our core business is actually electrical cable fittings. Then we have the adhesive side, and we also have a mining side. And believe it or not, a hair care side. Mm. Please don't look at their.
You beat me to it, but I'm not going to say anything. Yeah. That product works really well, doesn't it? Yeah.
And people often ask us, you know, where's the synergy between these various businesses? Yeah. And in fact, a lot of the R&D work we do on the electrical side, on polymers for the electrical side, cross-pollinates to the adhesive side and vice versa. Yeah. So there is technically actually quite a lot of synergy.
It was a real bulldozer, wasn't it?
It's a real bulldozer, yes. In fact, we lower it every now and again and start it.
Yeah.
Indeed, once a week, somebody climbs up there, sits on top of it and starts it to keep the engine going.
Did you buy the bulldozer? I mean, obviously you had a bulldozer.
No, we had the bulldozer already.
Yeah. Guys, this is really fascinating, and it's so nice to meet you, and also nice to talk to a family business as well. Let us know what you think of this, the Pratley family, and our other stories on our social media pages. Until next time, goodbye to you. Thank you for watching.